father of nation. Today we are celebrating 154th birth of Gandhi ji. We have organized a celebrational program in memory of Gandhi Jayanti. Thank you for giving this opportunity.
Thank you, Pratibha ma'am.
Yes.
So Gandhi ji was a man with a grain of faith in God. Never loses hope because he never believes in the ultimate truth of truth. So now I request Sonia sir to come up on the stage to deliver his speech in English.
Respected principal sir, madam, the management side, my beloved staff, my beloved students,
which I was inspired. Everywhere we have witnessed freedom struggle, Americans. Here, Gandhiji was standing on a very great principle,
Satyagraha. And one great thing I have to underline, non-violence. If somebody hits you, immediately we think we have to hit him. But he never did that. Churchill was the Prime Minister of England. Those people asked him, the Senate, the Assembly, asked him, what? You cannot do anything. That man, one single man is fighting. You can't do anything. He said, I am very much ashamed. I can tackle any person, but this man with the lion claw, with just a dhoti, I can't do anything. They asked him, why? What's the reason? He said, I'm insulting him, I'm instigating him, I'm making so many things, but he's not budging. He's not taking even a small stick. If he takes a small stick and tries to attack me, I will open my cannons and my guns. He is not giving any chance for me to wage a war on these freedom fighters. I'm really a failure. British Prime Minister, he's a very talented, very strong person, British Prime Minister Churchill. Then they thought, what is this? Yes, underline this, children, non-violence. Even you come across who wants to attack you, please don't attack. If you attack, don't attack. With non-violence and Satyagraha, he got his freedom. We are very grateful to this gentleman. Now clap hands for him. Now clap hands for him. Okay, this great soul is a God's gift to us. So we have to take so many things, so many lessons from this gentleman. 12th standard. You have Raka Akshakana, she'll give a very nice speech. There are little points which I wanted to tell, but she's going to tell you. So very, very important point regarding, you'll tell me later. So have a nice day. God bless you. Thank you.
So let's together embark on this spiritual journey, seeking the strength to be the change we wish to see in the world. With this, I invite Manjusha Kulkarni ma'am for the speech in Hindi.
Thank you ma'am. Respected principal sir, Preeti ma'am and Sanshekar sir and my dear teachers and my dear students. Aaj main Gandhi Jayanti ke upalaksh par aap sabhi ko unke bare mein kuch mahatvapurna baatein batane ja rahi hu. Aaya tha ek nanna sa balak 2 October ko is duniya mein. छोटे से छोटे छोटे हाथों में एक स्वतंत्र भारत का सौगात लिए 13 वर्ष की अवस्था में इनका कस्तूरबा से ब्याह हुआ और आगे की शिक्षा के लिए इनका विदेश को गमन हुआ। धीरे धीरे फिर इनको अपने भारत की दुर्दशा दिखी कि कैसे अंग्रेजों के आने से हमारा अपना ही देश में दमन हुआ। बहुत हुआ अब अत्याचार अंग्रेजों को होने वाली अब कठिनाई थी। साधारण सा था वो बालक, पर इसने अपनी एक अलग ही पहचान बनाई थी। अहिंसा था जिसका हाथी। प्यार और सत्य को जिसने अपना राह चुना। लोग प्यार से इन्हें बापू बुलाते थे और महात्मा की उपाधि भी इन्होंने ही कमाई थी। एक व्यक्ति मात्र थे असाधारण से, दुबली पतली सी जिनकी काया थी, पर वह हिम्मत ही थी इनकी जिसने हमें आजादी दिलाई थी। महापुरुष थे वे इस दौर के, वे हर युग में कहलाएंगे। जब जब दुस्साहस करे दुश्मन, तो हम भी इतिहास दोहराएंगे। वह मोहनदास करमचंद गांधी थे जो सदैव राष्ट्रपिता कहलाएंगे। और हर वर्ष इनके जन्मोत्सव हम बड़े हर्ष उल्लास के साथ मनाएंगे। तो बोलो मेरे साथ, जय हिंद जय भारत। थैंक यू।
नाउ आई रिक्वेस्ट माला मैम टू कम अप ऑन द स्टेज टू डिलीवर स्पीच इन कन्नड़ा। ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಮಧ್ಯಾಹ್ನದ ಶುಭಾಶಯಗಳು. ಇಂದು 2ನೇ ಅಕ್ಟೋಬರ್ ಅಂದು ನಾವು ಗಾಂಧಿ ಜಯಂತಿಯನ್ನು ಆಚರಣೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಮೊದಲನೇದಾಗಿ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಗಾಂಧಿ ಜಯಂತಿಯ ಶುಭಾಶಯಗಳು. ಗಾಂಧೀಜಿಯವರು ಅಕ್ಟೋಬರ್ 1869ರಲ್ಲಿ ಗುಜರಾತ್ನ ಪೋರಬಂದರ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಇವರು ಜನಿಸ್ತಾರೆ. ಇವರ ತಂದೆ ಹೆಸರು ಕರಮ್ಚಂದ ಗಾಂಧಿ, ಇವರ ತಾಯಿ ಹೆಸರು ಪುತಲಿ ಬಾಯಿ. ಗಾಂಧೀಜಿಯವರ ಪೂರ್ಣ ಹೆಸರು ಮೋಹನ್ದಾಸ್ ಕರಮ್ಚಂದ ಗಾಂಧಿ. ಗಾಂಧೀಜಿಯವರು ಪ್ರೀತಿ, ಶಾಂತಿ, ಪ್ರಾಮಾಣಿಕತೆ ಮತ್ತು ಸತ್ಯದ ಸಂಕೇತವಾಗಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಇವರು ನಮ್ಮ ಸ್ವಾತಂತ್ರ್ಯಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ತಮ್ಮ ಜೀವನವನ್ನೇ ತ್ಯಾಗ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವರು ತಮ್ಮ ಗುರಿಯನ್ನು ಸಾಧಿಸಲು ಸತ್ಯಾಗ್ರಹ ಮತ್ತು ಅಹಿಂಸೆಯಂತಹ ಸಾಧನಗಳನ್ನು ಇವರು ಬಳಸ್ತಾರೆ. ಗಾಂಧಿ ಜಯಂತಿಯನ್ನ ಗಾಂಧೀಜಿಯವರ ನೆಚ್ಚಿನ ಗೀತೆ ರಘುಪತಿ, ರಾಘವ, ರಾಜಾರಾಮ್, ಮಹಾತ್ಮ ಗಾಂಧೀಜಿಯವರನ್ನ ಪ್ರೀತಿಯಿಂದ ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರಪಿತ ಹಾಗೂ ಬಾಪು ಅಂತ ಕರೀತೇವೆ. ಗಾಂಧಿ ಜಯಂತಿ ಆಚರಿಸೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಎಲ್ಲರಲ್ಲೂ ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯತೆ ಮತ್ತು ದೇಶಭಕ್ತಿಯ ಭಾವನೆ ಉಂಟಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಗಾಂಧೀಜಿಯವರನ್ನು ನಮ್ಮ ಸ್ವಾತಂತ್ರ್ಯಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಹೋರಾಡುವಾಗ ಜನವರಿ 30, 1948 ನಾಥರಾಮ್ ಗೂಡ್ಸೆಯವರ ಗುಂಡಿಗೆ ಬಲಿಯಾಗಿ ಇವರು ವಿಧಿವಶರಾಗ್ತಾರೆ. ಗಾಂಧೀಜಿಯವರು ಇಂದಿನ ಮತ್ತು ಮುಂದಿನ ಪೀಳಿಗೆಗೆ ನಾವು ಮಾದರಿ ಅಂತಲೇ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು. ಗಾಂಧೀಜಿಯವರ ಮಾದರಿಗಳನ್ನು ನಾವು ಪಾಲನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ನನ್ನ ಈ ಎರಡು ಮಾತುಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾತಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಅವಕಾಶ ಕೊಟ್ಟ ತಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಧನ್ಯವಾದ. ಜೈ ಹಿಂದ್ ಜೈ ಭಾರತ್. Thank you, Mala ma'am. Yes, now for echoing the essence of Gandhiji's birth melodiously, now I request the beauty ma'am to come upon the stage to sing a song. Yes, put your hands together to beauty ma'am.
De di hume azadi bina khadak bina dhan sabarmati ke lal tujhe tune kar diya kamal. गांधी जयंती की बहुत बहुत बधाई आप सबको. आप सबको मेरा प्यार भरा नमस्कार. गांधी जयंती के अवसर पर मैं आपको एक गाना सुनाने जा रही हूँ.
ना टांगा तलवार, ना तिरछी धार कटार, ना कोई भी हथियार, बापू तेरा बंधन है, बापू तेरा बंधन है. तलवार ना तिरछी धार कटार, ना कोई भी हथियार, बापू तेरा बंधन है, बापू तेरा बंधन है. थे सत्य के पुजारी, दुश्मन पे पड़े भारी, थे सत्य के पुजारी, दुश्मन पे पड़े भारी, उनके धारे कटार ना कोई भी हथियार बापू तेरा बंधन है बापू तेरा बंधन है सारी दुनिया को लेके आगे हुए तैयार सारी दुनिया को लेके आगे हुए तैयार थी एकता बनाए आजादी आई हाथ में थी एकता बनाए आजादी आई हाथ में ना टांगा तलवार ना तिरछी धार कटार ना कोई भी हथियार बापू तेरा बंधन है बापू तेरा बंधन है ना टांगा तलवार ना तिरछी धार कटार ना कोई भी हथियार बापू तेरा बंधन है बापू तेरा बंधन है बापू तेरा बंधन है थैंक यू
वेरी मेलोडियस थैंक यू ब्यूटी मैम As we continue to celebrate the spirit of Gandhi Jayanti, we believe that the voices of our future leaders are just as important as the wisdom of our present one. I welcome our exceptional students who will share their perspectives on Mahatma Gandhiji's life and his teaching. So I request Jatin to come up on the stage and deliver a speech. Jatin.
सभी को मेरा सुप्रभात मैं जतिन 10वीं कक्षा में पढ़ता हूँ और मैं यहाँ गांधी जी के जीवन के कुछ रोचक तत्व बताने आया हूँ तो गांधी जी ने कहा था मेरा जीवन मेरा संदेश है 2 अक्टूबर 1869 को पोरबंदर में पैदा हुए मोहनदास करमचंद गांधी एक वकील सामाजिक कार्यकर्ता राजनीतिज्ञ और लेखक थे वह भारतीय स्वतंत्रता के लिए राष्ट्रवादी आंदोलन में प्रमुख बने यह अनेक विवाह कार्यों के लिए ही है कि उन्हें राष्ट्रपति के रूप में सम्मानित किया गया है और इसी सम्मान के चलते हम हर साल 2 अक्टूबर को गांधी जयंती मनाते हैं जिसे राष्ट्रीय अवकाश भी घोषित किया गया है उन्होंने भारत के स्वतंत्रता संग्राम में बहुत प्रमुख भूमिका निभाई है उनके नेतृत्व में दांडी मार्च भारत असहयोग आंदोलन आदि किए गए जो कोई भी जानता था कि स्वतंत्रता से पहले भारत में जीवन कैसा होता था वह गांधी जी के साथ मिलकर चला है और हमें स्वतंत्रता दिलाने में अपना पूरा सहयोग दिया है आज हम में से प्रत्येक को यह याद दिलाने हैं कि कैसे हमारे बहुत से लोग हमारे स्वतंत्रता के लिए अपनी जान गंवा चुके हैं और हमें उनका आभारी होना चाहिए जी हमें किस तरह का जीवन जीना चाहिए यह भी हमें मोहनदास करमचंद गांधी जी ने सिखाया है आइए हम सभी एक एक दिन करके अपने जीवन को अधिक सार्थक रूप में जीना शुरू करें और हम अपनी युवा पीढ़ी को प्रेरित करें कि वह इस भारत को प्रगतिपूर्ण करने के लिए अपना पूरा सहयोग दें और महात्मा गांधी जी ने एक बहुत अच्छी चीज़ कही है कि व्यक्ति अपने विचारों से निर्मित प्राणी है वह जो सोचता है वह कर दिखाता है और आज समय कम होने के कारण मैं यहीं अपना भाषण समाप्त करता हूँ धन्यवाद
थैंक यू जतिन नाउ आई इनवाइट लिखित ऑफ क्लास 10 टू डिलीवर स्पीच इन इंग्लिश
गुड आफ्टरनून टू एवरीवन माय नेम इज लिखित आई एम फ्रॉम 10th स्टैंडर्ड नाउ आई एम हियर टू गिव स्पीच अबाउट महात्मा गांधी My life is my message, said by Mahatma Gandhi. Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi was born on October 2, 1869 in Porbandar. He was a lawyer, social activist, politician and also a lawyer. He became the head of Nationalist Movement for Indian Independence. He is also known as Father of Nation. It is to honor him that we celebrate Gandhi Jayanti on the 2nd of October every year. Which is also declared as a national holiday. He played a very prominent role of Indian freedom struggle movement like the non-cooperation movement, Quit India movement, Dandi March, etc. These were all carried out by the East leadership. Anyone who knows how life was in the pre-independent India would never fail to appreciate the kind of work Mahatma Gandhiji has done for the country. Today is just another day to remind each of us how grateful we should live and the kind of life we should aspire to lead. And we should try to live our life best in much more meaningful way. Let every Indian consider himself to be a free man. Thank you.
Thank you, Lokit. Now, to continue this program meliviously, I invite Rashmi and team on the stage to sing a song.
कामयाब एक दिन।
Thank you, girls. Gandhiji strongly believed in God. To him, God was life, truth, love, ethics, light of morality, and fearlessness. With this, I request Rupa K. Ma'am to come upon the stage and deliver a few quotes from the holy book.
Good afternoon, everyone. Respected Principal Sir, my dear colleagues and dear students. First of all, I wish you a happy Gandhi Jayanti for everyone. ನಮ್ಮ ಹಿಂದೂ ಧರ್ಮದ ಪವಿತ್ರ ಗ್ರಂಥಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದಾದ ಭಗವದ್ಗೀತೆಯ ಒಂದು ಶ್ಲೋಕವನ್ನು ನಾನು ಈಗ ಹೇಳಲು ಇಚ್ಛಿಸುತ್ತಿದ್ದೇನೆ. ಯದಾ ಯದಾ ಹಿ ಧರ್ಮಸ್ಯ ಗ್ಲಾನಿರ್ಭವತಿ ಭಾರತ ಅಭ್ಯುತಾನಾಮ ಧರ್ಮಸ್ಯ ತದಾತ್ಮನಂ ಸ್ಮರಾಣ್ಯಹಂ ಪರಿತ್ರಾಣಾಯ ಸಾಧೂನಾಂ ವಿನಾಶಾಯ ಚ ದುಷ್ಕೃತ ಧರ್ಮ ಸಂಸ್ಥಾಪನಾ ಕಾರ್ಯಾಂ ಸಂಭವಾಮಿ ಯುಗೇ ಯುಗೇ. ಈ ಶ್ಲೋಕದ ಅರ್ಥ, ನಮ್ಮ ಪ್ರಪಂಚದ ಮೇಲೆ ಅಧರ್ಮ, ಹಿಂಸೆ, ಅಸತ್ಯ ಎಲ್ಲ ಯಾವಾಗ ಹೆಚ್ಚಾಗಿ ದುಷ್ಕರ್ಯಗಳು ಹೆಚ್ಚಾಗುತ್ತೋ ಆಗ ಪ್ರತಿಯುಗದಲ್ಲೂ ನಮ್ಮ ತ್ರಿಮೂರ್ತಿಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಒಬ್ಬರಾದಂತಹ ವಿಷ್ಣುಮೂರ್ತಿ ಪ್ರತಿಯುಗದಲ್ಲೂ ಸ್ವಯಂ ಅವತರಿಸಿ ಶಿಷ್ಟರನ್ನು ರಕ್ಷಿಸಿ ಮತ್ತು ದುಷ್ಟರನ್ನು ಸಂಹಾರ ಮಾಡಿ ನ್ಯಾಯ, ಧರ್ಮ ಮತ್ತು ಸತ್ಯವನ್ನು ಪುನಃ ಈ ಪ್ರಪಂಚದಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಥಾಪಿಸುತ್ತೇನೆ ಎಂದು. ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಗಾಂಧಿ ಜಯಂತಿ. ನಮ್ಮ ಗಾಂಧೀಜಿಯವರು ಸಹ ಅವರ ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ಮೂರು ತತ್ವಗಳನ್ನು ಪಾಲಿಸುತ್ತಿದ್ದರು, ಸತ್ಯ, ಶಾಂತಿ ಮತ್ತು ಅಹಿಂಸೆ. ಅವರ ಆ ತತ್ವಗಳನ್ನು ನಾವು ಮತ್ತು ನೀವು ಸಹ ನಮ್ಮ ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಳವಡಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳಬೇಕು. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಪರ್ಚುನಿಟಿ.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ರೂಪಾ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್. ನಾವು ಐ ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಲ್ಲ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಟು ಕಮ್ ಅಪ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ಅಂಡ್ give away the quotes from the holy book Bible.
Afternoon to everyone. I wish you all happy Gandhi Jayanti. Today I am here present to say a few words from Bible. In this Gospel, Luke chapter 8 and verse 22 to 25 verses 22. One day Jesus and his disciples got into a boat and he said, "Let's cross the lake." They started out, and while they were sailing across, Jesus went to sleep. Suddenly windstorm struck the lake and the boat started sinking. They were in danger, so they went to see Jesus and woke him up. "Master, master, we are about to drown." Jesus got up and ordered the wind and waves stopped. They obeyed and everything was calm. Then Jesus asked the disciples, "Don't you have any faith?" The word of God. Amen. When Jesus asked disciples, "Where is your faith?" These disciples were desperate. Their lives were in danger. They thought they could perish. Their faith was weak, but in their weakness they called out to Jesus, and he heard them and rescued them. Then Jesus reminded the disciples that God is bigger than storm. God has the ability to stop the storm without a single word. Faith and truth is very important. When you praise the Lord, without faith you can't receive any blessing from God. Thank you.
Thank you, Stella ma'am. Now I would request Shobha ma'am to come up on the stage for a beautiful song.
Good afternoon, everyone. Respected Principal Sir, my dear teachers and my lovely students. Happy Gandhi Jayanti to one and all.
Hindustanu yendu marayada Bharat ratnau neenagu. Hindustanu yendu marayada Bharat ratnau neenagu. Kannada hirimeya maganagu. Kannada nuduya siriyagu.
ಜಯ ಜಯವಾಗಲೆಂದು ನಾವು ಹಾಡುವ
continue this, I would request Prema ma'am to come upon the stage and ellarigu mattume Gandhi Jayanti shubhashayagalu. Mahatma Gandhi Jivara sadhane apara, avara marga ahimsa marga mattu avara shramada phala namage dorita swatantra. So ivugalnella ondu haadina roopadalli helalu nanu illi bandiddene.
ಅಕ್ಟೋಬರ್ ಎರಡನ ದಿನ ಗಾಂಧಿ ಜಯಂತಿಯು ಇಂದು ಬನ್ನಿ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೂಡಿ ಹಾಡುವ ಅವರನ್ನು ನೆನಪಿಗೆ ತಂದು ಅಕ್ಟೋಬರಿನ ಎರಡನ ದಿನ ಗಾಂಧಿ ಜಯಂತಿಯು ಇಂದು ಬನ್ನಿ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೂಡಿ ಹಾಡುವ ಅವರನ್ನು ನೆನಪಿಗೆ ತಂದು ಅವರನ್ನು ನೆನಪಿಗೆ ತಂದು ಸಣಕಲು ದೇಹದ ಗಾಂಧಿ ಸತ್ಯಹಿಂಸೆಯೇ ಆಧಾರ ಸಣಕಲು ದೇಹದ ಗಾಂಧೀಜಿಗೆ ಸತ್ಯಹಿಂಸೆಯೇ ಆಧಾರ ಇವುಗಳ ಎದುರು ನಡೆಯದಾಯಿತು ಆಂಗ್ಲರ ಆಳಿಕೆ ದರ ಭಾರ ಇವುಗಳ ಎದುರು ನಡೆಯದಾಯಿತು ಆಂಗ್ಲರ ಆಳಿಕೆ ದರ ಭಾರ ಅಕ್ಟೋಬರಿನ ಎರಡನೇ ದಿನ ಗಾಂಧಿ ಜಯಂತಿ ಇಂದು ಬನ್ನಿ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೂಡಿ ಹಾಡುವ ಅವರನ್ನು ನೆನಪಿಗೆ ತಂದು ಅವರನ್ನು ನೆನಪಿಗೆ ತಂದು ಅನೀತಿ ದಾರಿ ತುಳಿಯಲೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ನುಡಿಯಲೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ಹುಸಿಯನ್ನು ಅನೀತಿ ದಾರಿ ತುಳಿಯಲೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ನುಡಿಯಲೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ಹುಸಿಯನ್ನು ಪ್ರಾಣ ಹೋದರೂ ಲೆಕ್ಕಿಸಲಿಲ್ಲ ಬಾಗಲೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ತಲೆಯನ್ನು ಪ್ರಾಣ ಹೋದರೂ ಲೆಕ್ಕಿಸಲಿಲ್ಲ ಬಾಗಲೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ತಲೆಯನ್ನು ಅಕ್ಟೋಬರಿನ ಎರಡನೇ ದಿನವು ಗಾಂಧಿ ಜಯಂತಿಯು ಇಂದು ಬನ್ನಿ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೂಡಿ ಹಾಡುವ ಅವರನ್ನು ನೆನಪಿಗೆ ತಂದು ಅವರನ್ನು ನೆನಪಿಗೆ ತಂದು ಶ್ರಮದ ಪಾಠವ ದೇಶಕ್ಕೆ ಕಲಿಸಿ ಒಳ್ಳೆಯ ದಾರಿಯ ತೋರಿದರು ಶ್ರಮದ ಪಾಠವ ದೇಶಕ್ಕೆ ಕಲಿಸಿ ಒಳ್ಳೆಯ ದಾರಿಯ ತೋರಿದರು ಹುಚ್ಚ ನೀಚ ಭಾವವ ಅಳಿಸಿ ಮಧುರ ಪ್ರೀತಿಯ ಬೀರಿದರು ಹುಚ್ಚ ನೀಚ ಭಾವವ ಅಳಿಸಿ ಮಧುರ ಪ್ರೀತಿಯ ಬೀರಿದರು ಅಕ್ಟೋಬರಿನ ಎರಡನೇ ದಿನವು ಗಾಂಧಿ ಜಯಂತಿಯು ಇಂದು ಬನ್ನಿ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೂಡಿ ಹಾಡುವ ಅವರನ್ನು ನೆನಪಿಗೆ ತಂದು ಅವರನ್ನು ನೆನಪಿಗೆ ತಂದು ಅವರನ್ನು ನೆನಪಿಗೆ ತಂದು
Thank you, Prema ma'am. That was really melodious. Now I would invite our very talented student, Syed Aksa, from first PUC to deliver a speech. Syed Aksa. Respected principal, dear teachers, and all my dear friends, a very good afternoon to one and all present here. I am Syed Aksa from First Pre-University College. As we all know, today we all have gathered here to celebrate the birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. This day is also celebrated as International Day of Non-Violence all across the world. On this day, educational institutes organize various cultural and academic programs to develop the value of leadership, simplicity and non-violence. He was born on 2nd October 1869 in Parbandar, a small city in Gujarat. His full name is Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. His father name was Paramchand Gandhi and mother name was Putli Bai Dears, Maharet freedom fighter, writer, philosopher, secularist, socialist and above all an Indian politician. Yes, he is a myth and superhero during the Indian freedom struggle. We will always remember Bapu as a symbol of peace and truth. He was a man of simple living and high thinking. Mahatma Gandhi fought against British domination and finally he sacrificed his valuable life for us. Really, his life is a good message to us. One incident occurred in early life of Gandhiji I want to discuss with you all, which gives us a very good lesson. In early life, Gandhiji did not had a very good handwriting. Once when he had been to London, at that time he saw the handwriting of the lawyers, headmasters, all. And at that time he felt ashamed of himself because
they had a very good handwriting. With good knowledge, they had good handwriting also. But though Gandhiji being so much educated person, so much knowledgeable person, he did not had a very good handwriting. When he wanted to correct himself, he found that his age was now not like to improve himself. So he gave a message to youth that when you want to improve anything in your life, you must take step from beginning, not after you become grown up member. So all of you, let's wish a very happy Gandhi Jayanti to us, and all of you say with me, Mahatma Gandhi ki. Mahatma Gandhi ki. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Aksa. Now I would request Preeti ma'am and all the teachers to come upon the dais. Preeti ma'am and all the teachers together.
Thank you. He has been guiding all of us towards excellence. It is now my honor to invite our respected principal sir, Sri Ramakrishnappa sir, on the stage to share his thoughts.
No nonsense. This is a very serious moment. We are celebrating the 154th birth anniversary of the most serious person who took his life seriously and made the whole world serious about himself and also about life. Many students, many teachers have spoken from this platform about the significance of this occasion. All over the country, perhaps all over the world, wherever the Indian embassies are there, wherever India has established embassies, this program is being celebrated. It is very, very important for all of us to remember the contributions made by that great soul, that great personality, who spent his entire life like a piece of camphor or like a candle which burns itself to give light to others. Gandhiji melted his life to give light to others, to give life to more than 42 crore people of India. At that time, the population of the country was not correctly assessed, but according to some economists, we were 42 crores when the independence struggle was going on in India. Our teachers have taken a lot of pain to give all of us pleasure from this platform.
Mahabharata only 106 crore.
And everybody who spoke here, everybody who sang here, very clearly exhibited that they are teachers of talents, are teachers with the talents. A teacher must become more and more talented as he gives more and more service to his students. So this program has very clearly reflected the teamwork of our teachers, and the students could not participate very freely in this program because they are going through this nonsense, academic nonsense. What is that?
Examination.
Examination is an academic nonsense actually. Because we test you in 1.5 hours to 2.5 hours to 3 hours for what you have learned in the period of 4 or 5 months. And in 3 hours time, we try to assess you what you have learned in the course of one academic year. So though you are very busy with that nonsensical work,
you also participated wholeheartedly in this program. What is Gandhi's teaching to us? You know, because all your textbooks, starting from first standard, and even in kindergarten lessons, there are some principles which have been taught to us by Gandhi. Gandhiji means not only his principles, he means everything to the whole world. He was not the property of the one country. He became the property of the whole world. One student who spoke here rightly mentioned that today, even the United Nations organization is celebrating Gandhiji's birthday as World Non-Violence Day. World Non-Violence Day. This is the significance, this is the contribution, this is the image, this is the character, this is the personality which has been exhibited by Gandhiji to the whole world. Why should we be non-violent? We should be non-violent because violence does not bring you anything. Violence brings only bloodshed, death, disaster. We take centuries and centuries to build a civilization, to construct a civilization. And that great civilization can be reduced into ashes by just a spark of violence. That's all. You have read in history what has happened to the great civilizations and how those great civilizations were reduced into ashes because of the violence exhibited by some idiotic minds and hearts. Peace builds civilization. Violence brings down civilization. Civilization is not merely construction of buildings. Civilization is the building of values. Civilization is giving life to everybody. Civilization is not merely in the river valley. It is all over, it is spread all over the world. And the civilization that has spread all over the world can be reduced to ashes by the mind of one violent person. So Gandhiji taught as a non-violence. Non-violence is not to hate even your enemy. See, it is very, very complex to understand the human mind. Human psychology. To analyze human psychology itself is man's lifelong effort. Even if you analyze your mind throughout your life, you cannot understand your own mind. I cannot understand my own mind. Gandhiji could not understand his own mind. And Gandhiji is considered as moral dictator of the world. See, political dictators were there. But there was, and to become a political dictator is very easy. And a worst personality like Adolf Hitler, who was responsible for the killing of millions and millions of people, became the dictator. And he ruled a country. Napoleon Bonaparte disturbed the peace of Europe for 25 continuous years, became the Emperor of France, and he ruled France. But their achievements are remembered all over the world only for conserving one stage of history, that's all. But Gandhiji is remembered has a vital contribution to the whole. His contribution is not only bringing independence to India, that is one phase of his life, one page of his life history. He was a social reformer, he was a social worker, and he had a sense of morality that he should never become bad in his life, he should never become evil in his life, and he never wanted anybody to become bad or evil in their lives. That is the greatest contribution of Gandhi. That is the reason why, irrespective of political differences, irrespective of different ideologies, all politicians all over the world, not only inside the country, all thinkers all over the world, all scholars all over the world, all educationists all over the world consider Gandhiji as a part of their family. There is a politician, there was a politician in Gandhiji. Without a politician in Gandhiji, how could he face the world politicians? And the world politicians just competed with each other to have a talk with Gandhi, to have a meeting with Gandhi. Every great thinker of the world, every great scientist of the world, Albert Einstein came to India and he met Gandhiji. Because Albert Einstein felt that he was morally responsible for the destruction of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, where millions and billions of companies were killed. And Gandhiji was teaching the lesson of non-violence. And Albert Einstein came to India. He met Gandhiji. He had a long interview with Gandhiji. And he discussed the problem of violence all over. So that was the greatness of Gandhiji. Never went to America. But Gandhiji's statues have been installed in more than 40 big cities of America. And many more cities are copying. Many more statues of Gandhiji are coming up. And what about Indians? There is no place where Gandhiji has not conquered. Every nook and corner, every heart of India is dedicated to Gandhiji, is grateful to Gandhiji. And there was only one person who hated Gandhiji, that's the reason why he killed him. And he became a demon for the generations and generations to come. And there are more than 100 universities in the world which have prescribed Gandhiji's thought as a part of their university education. And in IAS examinations, if you face IAS examinations after your studies, you come across a chapter, you come across a paper where there is Gandhian thought. Gandhian thought is a part of your IAS or APS study. That is because of the relevance of Gandhi. Gandhiji was relevant when he was alive. He became relevant after he died, and he would remain relevant for generations and generations to come because he stood for peace, truth, and non-violence. These are the three guiding principles which can keep this world safe. And these are the three guiding principles which can make everybody's life truthful, meaningful, valuable. That is the relevance. Look at the inevitable smile on his face. And thousands of psychologists have studied the meaning of that smile. Gandhiji was considered as a very grave person, always very serious, because he was burdened by responsibility, burdened by difficulties, and he had to do some serious work. He had no time even to smile. But whenever he brought a smile on his face, whenever he showed his intense love for life, people guessed were attracted to that magnetic smile. And there is no personality in the whole world about whom thousands and thousands of articles, thousands and thousands of stories, thousands and thousands of books, thousands and thousands of songs are written. So he became our leader. He has continued to be our leader. He will continue to be our leader. That is why India has a great status, a special status in the whole world. And I congratulate once again all our teachers and students who raised this program in such a beautiful manner, in a very meaningful manner. And thank you for that. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. As you always grace us with your words of wisdom and inspiration, please put your hands together once again. So as we have reached to the end of this event, we have immersed ourselves with the teaching of Gandhiji, and we pay tribute to his life and united in the spirit of truth and non-violence. Just as Gandhiji once said, "You must be the change you want to see in the world." So let's carry forward this message of love, unity and service in our hearts. I request Manisha ma'am to come upon the stage and deliver the yes, to deliver a word of thanks. Good evening, children. So, for every end, there is a start.
Good evening.
For every start, there is an end. So, for this event, this is the end of the program. So, on this time, on the occasion of Gandhi Jayanti, a non-violence day, I would like to thank our Honorable Principal Sir Ramakrishna Prasad, Sir, who has always been as a power engine for us and inspiration to achieve more and more. I would like to thank our PK Ma'am and Somshikar Sir, who has been a backbone to us to do all our events in a successful manner. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. I would also like to thank all our teachers who took part in all the events and made the event a successful one. Thank you, teachers. Not last but the least, I would like to thank all the students who took part in this event and sat silently and listened, being the audience of this event, who have been here. Thank you, children. Yes, on this occasion of Gandhi Jayanti, what did we learn? Did we learn anything? What did we learn? One thing was important thing that we learned was non-violence is a powerful weapon. Fighting with a gun and fighting with a sword, you have seen in most of the movies, right? But non-violence is a powerful weapon to fight against evil. That is what Bapuji, our Gandhiji has taught us. So let us follow non-violence and fight against the evil. Okay? Thank you. Thank you, Manisha ma'am. Yes, once again, a happy Gandhi Jayanti to all of you with the peace and with the teaching of Gandhi Jayanti. Yes, we will continue the patriotism. All the high school, 10th standard, please take your sweets and go to the classes.